democracy is not only political. Political thing, something which pertains to social life, to economic relationships, and so on. So, in general, in this moment, in general, I mean, in the world, the worst enemy of democracy, in my opinion, is the neoliberal dictatorship. I call it neoliberal dictatorship in the precise sense of the destruction of a possibility of real self-government by the people. Look at Greece, for instance. In Greece, there was a government which had been elected by the majority of the people, the Papandreou government. When Papandreou is obliged by this European Central Bank, which is a monetarist and neoliberal entity, when Papandreou is obliged to accept a certain kind of economic measures, he says, I want to ask my people if they agree or not. What happens is that overnight he is obliged to resign, and a new government is created in his place, a non-elected government whose president, Mr. Papademos, is a consultant of the financial class, namely of Goldman Sachs. So you see that the possibility of... you cannot speak of democracy in this sense, although people go to vote and so on. You vote for a government, but when this government has to decide something which is vital for the life of the people and for the interests of the banks, democracy is cancelled. Okay, so you have a similar problem now in the Arab countries, especially in Egypt, where it is so urgent. Mm-hmm. And of course, I agree with you when you say that in the dilemma between a liberal democracy and the fundamentalist state is a real dilemma, and of course everybody has to choose on something which means democracy, freedom, and so on. But wait a minute, who exactly are the liberals, and who exactly are the so-called authoritarian? And if I don't know the Egyptian reality enough to give a statement on this point, but if I think to what I know about the Muslim Brotherhood, for instance, which is an important part of the Egyptian society at the moment, I would say that it's a sort of ambiguous organization, ideology, and party, where neoliberalism and religious identitarianism can go together. Frankly, I think that in the Egyptian reality, the enemies of democracy are two. The first enemy is neoliberalism, because the misery of Egyptian workers, the salaries of $60 for the workers of the Nile Delta, and so on, are an effect of the politics.